thunderstorm, high of 91. And in Traverse City on Sunday, it's mostly sunny and 76. Again, today they're looking at a high of 89 with sunshine in Traverse. We're looking for the high today right around 87. Currently at Metro 84, fair skies, wind is east at 6, humidity at 61%.
Hi, it's Brett Brzezinski, president of the Brzezinski Group and host of Inside Retirement, airing every weekend here on WWJ 950. If these unsettling times have you worried about your retirement plan, we want to help. Schedule a complimentary virtual meeting today where my team and I will listen to your concerns and offer guidance. Call 1-800-641-3361 or visit MaximizeMyRetirement.com. In order to help during these uncertain times, we are offering a complimentary portfolio stress test to evaluate if you are still on track for retirement, and if not, ways to help get you back to achieving your goals. Set up your virtual meeting today. Call 1-800-641-3361 or visit MaximizeMyRetirement.com. Get your complimentary portfolio stress test from the comfort and safety of your own home. Call the Brzezinski Group at 1-800-641-3361 or visit MaximizeMyRetirement.com.
Investment advisory services offered through AE Wealth Management, LLC. Investing involves risk, including potential loss of principal.
Live and local. Detroit's number one news station. News Radio 950 WWJ.
Good afternoon. I'm Mike Campbell. Our top story at 1231. Things are improving, but far from perfect on US 23, where one crash has cleared, but another one is still an issue. WWJ's Tracy McCaskill joins us live with the latest.
And this is unfolding in Monroe County. Still watching a collision along north on US 23 after M50 near Dundee that's blocking all lanes. In the 8 a.m. hour, a truck hit a railroad bridge, shutting down the freeway for a few hours. You can exit at M50 and take northbound Annover Road and rejoin northbound US 23 near the scene of a second crash after Calm Road that is still blocking the left lane and shoulder. I'll have another update at 12:38. Reporting live, Tracy McCaskill, WWJ News Radio 950.
Well, the Dream Cruise officially may be starting tomorrow, but many people are already lined up along Woodward to watch the class. Classics roll by. Dennis Denyer of Lake Orion says it's like the best car show in the world.
If we sit here and the cars come to us, what more could you ask?
What kind of car are you looking for?
All of them. All of them. They're all fascinating.
What was your first car?
First car was a Dodge, a 64 Dodge. And I've had Chrysler products, I've got a Chrysler product, and I've got two Porsches.
The Dream Cruise has many people looking back at their favorite cars from the past years. For Oakland County Executive Dave Coulter.
A 1971 Pontiac Grand Prix. It had big bucket seat, and I'm not a car guy, to be honest with you. It's kind of odd coming from Michigan, but I loved that car. It had big bucket seats. It had a big old engine. Don't ask me how many horsepower, because I don't know, but it was really fast, and it was really cool, and it was one of the first cars I learned to drive on.
Keep pointing for that, and it was a lot faster than my 69 Mustang with a straight six. Coulter says he didn't grow up cruising Woodward. He cruised Gratiot as a teen. The official Woodward Dream Cruise runs tomorrow. A Michigan State Police captain says he wants to be the state's next governor. Mike Brown, who commands the State Police Southwest Michigan District, has announced he will run on the Republican ticket in the 2022 election. The 56-year-old Brown says Michigan is heading in the wrong direction. He'll be going up against former Detroit Police Chief James Craig, who also has his eyes set on the governor's mansion. The new host of a popular TV game show has quit after an uproar over some past comments. Richards has quit as host of Jeopardy after an uproar over demeaning comments about women he made in the past. He said staying on would be too much of a distraction for fans. Show producers will now take the time to find a new permanent host. In the meantime, guest host will again be used for the upcoming new season. Jim Crisilla, CBS News. Hurricane Grace is expected to hit Mexico City for a second time around midnight tonight. Here's CBS's Adrian Bard from Mexico.
On its first hit, Grace left the laid-back Caribbean beach resort Tulum battered. The roofs blew off some of the signature thatched roof hotels. Thousands of tourists had to ride out the storm in shelters. Fortunately, there were no casualties. Grace is now headed to a much more populated area. The warnings for floods and hailstorms include Mexico City, where nearly 20 20 million people live.
Mexican armies evacuating coastal fishing villages near Poza Rica, Veracruz, where heavy flooding is expected. People in Haiti are still waiting for life-saving aid 6 days after an earthquake.
This is the second major earthquake a generation of Haitians have survived.
You've got a pretty good weekend here, which really now looks like
Lake as well. 87 in Canton at this hour. Back at Metro, skies are fair. Humidity is at 61%, and the winds are east at 6 miles an hour. Updates of traffic and weather together every 10 minutes on the 8s around the clock. Our next update is less than 10 minutes away at 12:48. WWJ News Time is now 12:41. Macy's is bringing back the Toys R Us brand.
Macy's has seen an uptick in toy sales during the pandemic. It's doubling down on the trend by partnering with retailer Toys R Us, expanding its footprint in the toy market. Macy's announced Thursday it plans to include in-store Toys R Us shops in over 400 locations by next year. The news is especially exciting for nostalgic millennials who remember growing up with the brand. Ed Corey, WWJ News Radio 950.
Something else that's back, it's racing at MIS this weekend. A win there for one NASCAR driver with local roots would end years of frustration.
Since joining NASCAR back in 2010, Rochester Hills native Brad Keselowski has won just about everything imaginable except a NASCAR race held in Michigan. In his 22 career races at MIS, Keselowski has yet to finish first. He's come close three times, finishing second in 2012, 2018, and last year. And much like Ahab chasing Moby Dick, the quest for that elusive Michigan win continues to plague him.
Someone wants so bad to win races at the Cup level. You know, you run in the top five, and things will fall your way. We've done that a lot here. We've run in the top five, and it hasn't come together, hasn't fallen our way. And I just got to believe in the back of my head that it's there. And that it will if we keep doing what the things that we've been doing, but it hasn't yet.
Tony Ortiz, WWJ News Radio 950.
WWJ News Time, 12:42. Time for Black Business Minute, sponsored by Delta Dental.
Two best friends join forces to create a powerhouse PR, marketing, and events firm. I'm Vicki Thomas with Black Business Minute.
Happy being in business with my bestie. Happy to continue to be an example of black girl magic.
Chandra Lewis is COO and co-founder of the Allen Lewis Agency. She left corporate America to start the business in May of 2015.
No regrets. It's a growing trend among black women who may not be seeing the successes that they like to see in corporate America. Entrepreneurism is definitely the way to go.
Joycelyn Coley, the other co-founder and CEO, says the pandemic forced them to do things differently along with their clients.
Events are also a mainstay for us, so as clients are trying to figure out, again, how do I connect with my consumer base, my stakeholders in this virtual world, we're here to help them do that.
How can you reach them?
We're on Instagram, we're on Twitter, we're on Facebook, the Allen Lewis Agency, or at the handle TryTala, TryTala, or you can just go to the AllenLewisAgency.com and you can find us there.
With Black Business Minute, I'm Vicki Thomas.
Dental believes that the health and the wealth of our communities depend on the rich diversity of the people who live there. Education, opportunity, and capital are key to building prosperity, but so are cheerleaders, advocates, allies. That's why we are committed to create, elevate, celebrate, and support minority-owned businesses and minority entrepreneurs. Our company purpose is to build healthy, smart, vibrant, and inclusive communities. We need everyone to get that job done. I'm Margaret Trimmer, Vice President of Strategic Partnerships for Delta Dental. For the ones going above and beyond. For the ones reaching out, helping out, and lending a hand. For the ones people count on. You can count on Grainger. Grainger offers supplies and solutions for every industry, backed by 24/7 customer support and specialists to help with hard-to-find products. Because you've got everyone's back. We've got yours. Call, click Grainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger. For the ones who get it done.
You and your phone have been through a lot this past year. It's been your lifeline to the world. And now some big wireless company is telling you you gotta buy a new phone from them and sign their contract? They don't control you. With Smartphone Wireless, you can keep the phone, number, and network you already have. Already got a 5G phone? Keep that too. Because Smartphone runs on America's best networks now with 5G nationwide. Plus, they've got unlimited talk and text smartphone plans starting at just $20.
Melodic and always in the mood. a higher risk of myocarditis in younger adults than previously thought. At the same time, though, they say myocarditis is still rare, and that the benefits of getting the COVID vaccine continue to outweigh the risks of getting COVID itself.
A new health concern for pot-smoking teens.
A new UK study finds teens who frequently use marijuana are more likely to have a premature or low birth weight baby later in life compared to parents who haven't used marijuana as teens. The 20-year study found that to be true for both men and women.
It's the first study to show cannabis use could have intergenerational risks. A mea culpa from the Lions' new head coach, Dan Campbell, addressing his firing of long snapper Don Muehlbach after 17 years on the team. Muehlbach, pardon me. It happened on Muehlbach's birthday. Played the second most games in franchise history behind kicker Jason Hansen. Voice actor Jody Benson is the latest addition to the Motor City Comic Con. You may recognize Benson as the original voice of Ariel in The Little Mermaid. She's also known for the voice of Barbie in Toy Story 2 and Toy Story 3, among numerous other roles she has played. In 2011, Benson became a recipient of the prestigious Disney Legends Award for her more than 30 years working with the company. Benson will be at Motor City Comic Con all 3 days of the convention, October 15th through the 17th. It'll be held at the Suburban Collection Showplace in Novi. Others scheduled to appear include Ice-T and Coco, Giancarlo Esposito, and Alexander Ludwig, to name a few. Coming up in 2 minutes on News Radio 950, the Jeep Grand Wagoneer gets a review from our Car Chronicle reporter, Jeff Gilbert. Details coming up. But first, the update of traffic and weather together. Let's check the roads again. Here is Tracy McCaskill.
And this report's sponsored by the Michigan Department of Health and Human Services. Checking the AAA Jam Cams here, just clearing in Monroe County. This crash along northbound US 23 after M50 near Dundee. Traffic is still slow up to Cone Road, where an earlier crash is still blocking that left lane. A new crash here, this along northbound M10 on the ramp to westbound Davidson Avenue. A collision northbound M10 at Telegraph. It's blocking the two right lanes here. Traffic is very slow as you make your way by. And we're still watching a delay for a collision northbound I-75 at Grange Hall Road. It's blocking the left lane and shoulder. Plus the ongoing delays for road work affecting 75 northbound after Sacheverell. Single lane closed here through late afternoon. And brake lights for this work eastbound I-94 from East Grand Boulevard to Van Dyke, where a left lane closure continues with the backups to I-75. Protect yourself from the COVID variants by getting fully vaccinated. Discover the facts at michigan.gov/COVID-vaccine. That's traffic from the St. Joseph Mercy Health System Traffic Center.
Now we get the updated AccuWeather forecast, and it's from the Bill Brown Ford Weather Center.
The weather looks like a dream this weekend, and hopefully your cruising will be too. Temperatures up in the upper 80s this afternoon with sun and clouds, and temperatures tonight down the upper 60s, low 70s. Tomorrow is going to be a day where we're in the upper 80s to near 90, but even with some building clouds, we stay dry. We could get a shower thunderstorm on Sunday, mid upper 80s, and then upper 80s to near 90, and maybe even better than that the rest of next week. I'm AccuWeather meteorologist Steve DeVore, WWJA News Radio 950.
84 at Metro, 84 in Walled Lake, 87 in Canton, 80 in Sterling Heights. Back at Metro, fair skies being reported. Wind is east at 6 miles an hour, and the humidity is at 61%. Updates of traffic and weather together every 10 minutes on the 8th, so around the clock. Our next update is less than
luxury techno luxury with seven screens and 75 inches of screen space. You're also surrounded by rich wood and a high-end Macintosh sound system. All of these high-end vehicles have their own appeal, and the Grand Wagoneer fits right into this unique segment of the market. Let's give it a full five stars. With a Court Chronicles test drive, I'm Jeff Gilbert, WWHA, Radio 950.
President Biden and Senator Bernie Sanders' $4.7 trillion infrastructure plans are a typical Washington bait and switch. Politicians raise taxes, promising roads and bridges, but then waste trillions on special interests and partisan priorities, rigging the system for the well-connected while harming workers' wages and crushing small businesses. Call 734-415-2159 and tell Congresswoman Haley Stevens to reject President Biden and Senator Sanders' phony infrastructure plans paid for by Americans for Prosperity.
If you're a father facing separation but want to avoid losing custody of your kids or paying too much in child support, call ADAM, the American Divorce Association for Men. With our proven advice, we can help you avoid problems before they start. Call us today at 248-356-2326. That's 248-356-2326.
I'm Mark Tapper, and the good fortune sale is ending soon at Tapper's Jewelry. And I'm Sir Richard Pushingham, urging you to ignore the rantings of a clearly deranged mind. What's wrong, Sir Richard? Afraid you might accidentally enjoy yourself? Call saving money fun. Have you gone mad? Just choose a fortune cookie. Look, your discount is inside. Fine, just to prove I'm above all this. Save anywhere from 20 to 50% off your purchase. They're saying, what is this here? This is how much I'll save. That's right. I couldn't possibly. Or even marking down items late in the sale to clear out last year's designs. The best deals are right now. But paying full price proves that I'm tremendously clever. Suit yourself. Visit Tapper's Jewelry for the good fortune sale. Restrictions apply. See store or website for details.
Up to $100 and free games when you sign up now with promo code radio at michiganlottery.com.
That was up $275. An update of your money coming up in just 2 minutes. 12:53, time for an update on sports from your Metro Detroit Chevy dealer sports desk. Here's Chris Pollard.
Little League World Series continuing today, and Taylor North, the representative from Michigan, set to begin their tournament at 3 p.m. this afternoon when they take on Florida during their first game in Williamsport, Pennsylvania. The tournament does not have any international teams this year due to travel and safety regulations. The quest for 500 moves on to Toronto after being swept by the Angels at home. Miguel Cabrera has 499 home runs, and the Tigers will start a five-game trip north of the border and take on the Blue Jays beginning tonight. First pitch at 7:07 on 97.1, the ticket. And after receiving a positive test for COVID-19, Lions legend Barry Sanders says he expects to be good to go for the team's opener in just over 3 weeks. Barry revealing the result in a tweet, which he said comes even though he wore a mask, was vaccinated, and being cautious. Meanwhile, the Lions themselves will take on the Pittsburgh Steelers on the road tomorrow night for an exhibition game, the second out of three. With sports 23 and 53 past each hour, Chris Pillar, WWJ News Radio 950.
Research shows that people remember radio ads with British accents. So to help you remember that Liberty Mutual Insurance Company customizes your home insurance so you only pay for what you need, take it from a Brit.
Oi, balmy insurance bloke, something dush out your pocket. It's balmy. Liberty Mutual won't leave your skin, mate.
Can you just say, Liberty Mutual customizes your home insurance so you only pay for what you need?
I think that's what I said, you're feeling.
Only pay for what you need at libertymutual.com.
Liberty. Hi, Tom Bodette from Motel 6, leaving the light on for families back on the road. Kids in suitcases jammed in the back, earbuds tangled in the dog, heading to see Aunt Jasmine and her rock garden. Admit it, you missed this. And Motel 6 has been missing you. With our clean, comfortable rooms and great low rates, we've been giving families on the move the perfect roadside rest for almost as long as Aunt Jasmine's been putting rocks in her yard. I'm Tom Bodette from Motel 6, and we'll leave the light on for you.
Big numbers on Wall Street. The update of the check of your money now here on News Radio 950. And we go to Bloomberg's Karen Chase with the details.
discussed Tesla's autopilot system, saying it's still being upgraded. He's also still working on those promised robo-taxis. His comments come as federal safety investigators open a probe into several accidents linked to the system. I'm Karen Chase with the Bloomberg Business Report on WWJ News Radio 950.
Thanks, Karen. The lottery numbers top of each hour on News Radio 950. They're about to draw the midday daily 3 and daily 4, the midday numbers. We'll have those coming up for you. Tonight, the Mega Millions at 11 o'clock were $256 million. Fantasy 5 up at $100,000. And we have the Poker Lotto up to and including $100,000 and Lucky for Life. You could win $1,000 a day for life.
Have you been lied to by Washington politicians and the Wall Street propaganda machine? I'm Mitch Lyons, former Michigan Face Bar, Pittsburgh Steeler, and now best-selling author from right here in Michigan, and I want to give you a free copy of my book, Retirement of Steel. According to Time Magazine, Wall Street's retirement plans and 401ks have failed millions of Americans. After seeing the last market crash of over 39%, I said enough. I've discovered a way to grow money, potentially double digits, and reduce taxes dramatically. And when the next market crash hits, you lose nothing. Call Mitch Lyons Wealth now to get a free copy of Retirement of Steel and talk to me to discover this little-known strategy to get potentially double-digit growth during good years and never lose when the next stock market crash hits. Call 1-800-578-3535 to discover this asset that people like Walt Disney and JCPenney use to grow wealthy. Don't expose your retirement to unnecessary risk or taxes. Get your Retirement of Steel. Call 1-800-578-3535. 1-800-578-3535. That's 1-800-578-3535.
Brought to you by Capital One Auto Navigator, where you can find a car, get pre-qualified instantly, and see your real monthly payment without impacting your credit score. Capital One, what's in your wallet? Terms and conditions apply. Find out more at CapitalOne.com/AutoNavigator.
WWJ News Time, 12:58. Traffic and weather together. Here's Tracy McCaskill.
Checking the AAA Jim Kent here in Monroe County. The crash northbound US 23 after Cone Road, still blocking the left lane and shoulder. Still a few delays due to an earlier crash near Dundee. It's recently cleared out of the way, though. A new crash here, this along eastbound I-94 after Huron Street in Ipsy. Traffic slow from Michigan Avenue. Also,